everybody. What an inspiring story. We are here to help you once and for all stop that yo-yo dieting. We've got Julia Havey, author of Vice Busting Diet. Good morning, Julia.
Hi, good morning. Thanks for having me.
Oh my gosh, first of all, congratulations. You lost a whopping 130 pounds?
130 pounds.
And you've kept it off for how long?
I have kept the majority of my weight off for 16 years now. When I hit age 40, I did gain some back, and I have it off now, and I'm thinner than I ever was now.
Good for you. Yeah. And you see the trick in losing, first of all, this is unbelievable. I thought this was maybe 10 pounds of fat. No.
Five.
Only five.
I lost 15 of those. Think about it. It would fill this entire table.
Oh my, look at the size in terms of scale. Like, I have long hands, but in comparison, this is 5 pounds of fat. So it seems impossible to lose.
Yeah.
The trick is baby steps.
Absolutely baby steps. I think we're so overwhelmed when it's day one of any diet you want to name. You take a person who's living, whether it's 50 pounds overweight, 5 pounds overweight, or 100, and you want them to change everything about their life just because it's day one of the diet. No wonder diets don't work.
Too drastic.
Way too drastic. Superhuman strength to stick with it. And even if you're lucky enough to stick with it, 98% of people who lose weight on a diet gain it back within 5 years, and 90% of them gain back more than they lost.
Now, is that because they're starving themselves, slowing their metabolism, and then going back to the foods that are their triggers, so they eat so much of it to make up for the years of deprivation that it comes back quicker? What is the reason?
I think that's a great explanation for it, but it really is more a matter of they just went back to the way they were living. Mm-hmm. They never changed their lifestyle. They just went on some short-term program and then went back to their old habits. You have to change your habits, or as I call them, vices.
So for example, if you're thinking today I need to lose weight, you suggest just start drinking water,
yep.
Trade it in for pop, something small, a small step.
One soft drink a day, and I believe it's an 8 ounce, puts 15 pounds a year on the human body. Yeah, absolutely. Just start drinking water. My whole process is one baby step at a time, which empowers the person. They feel like, yeah, you know what? I can actually stick with
this. I can do this.
Versus having them change everything and feel like, I'm a failure. I have no willpower. I can never do this.
This part is fascinating, too. You hear a lot with these diets where you can allow yourself a cheat day or a couple of cheat meals. What's your thoughts on that?
We need about a 3-hour show, but I don't think they're a good idea, because if something is unhealthy for you, why would you give permission to the person who's battling it to go ahead and have it? We're not so cruel as to tell an alcoholic, go ahead and just on Sunday have vodka.
Right.
We don't do that to someone. If it's unhealthy, it's unhealthy. So no, I would never say have a free day, because I've known too many people who that free day starts calling them on Tuesday, starts calling them on Thursday, and before you know it, you've blown your diet that you were on the other 6 days of the week.
So you say, for example, if your vice, find out what your vice, what your trigger is that you overindulge in.
Mm-hmm.
If it's cheesecake, if you buy a big cheesecake and think, I'm just going to have my slice on Sunday as my cheat treat, you're going to go back to that Monday and then Tuesday, and then you're, forget it, I'm off the wagon,
well,
I'm just going to stay off.
I would love an email from somebody who buys that cheesecake, really has the exact true portion size of it, and doesn't touch it again until Sunday. It doesn't happen.
Okay,
it just
so instead,
doesn't.
Go for chocolate if you don't love chocolate,
yeah,
if it's not your vice, so you satisfy
it.
That sweet craving.
Right, we've got to find a way to stick with the right portion sizes of our foods. We want to control blood sugar. I mean, that's a huge thing. We're eating cheesecake, raises your blood sugar outrageously, then you crash, then you want more of it.
Right.
So we need to help people find a way to live in the real world with a little bit of moderation of some unhealthy foods. I mean,
yeah.
You can't get around unhealthy foods in society today, but do it better with less damage to you.
And the more healthy you eat, the more you get into exercise, the more that continues. It's a self-fulfilling prophecy, which is interesting.
Exactly. I call it a self-empowering snowball
yeah.
effect. The more you do, the more you're going to want to do healthy
yeah.
actions. But don't do them all in day one, because you're going to fail.
Yeah, and don't keep it in the house, because you will eat it all. I know we all do that.
You will.
PGX.com for more information. It is called Vice Busting Diet. Take it from one who knows and is living proof. As well, you have a product and program on your website right now for free, so you can take advantage of all of her tried and true tips
mm-hmm.
to make sure you can get that weight off and keep it off. Send that fat sailing!
and free, what's better than that?
Did you mind that I just said that?
No.
I should have asked beforehand.
You can throw my fat around
felt
anytime
like
you want.
Literally throwing her